And we're approaching the end of the evening, but there are some interesting talks. So we have an alumna who will present about her experiences, and we will also hear about more internship opportunities. So if you still are not convinced about Futurize, you will get more convinced about the spin-off of Futurize, Columbia Road. So those are the two presentations we have right now. And first, I would like to welcome someone who studied with me in the same year of EIT Utah. And now she's an alumna who's working here in Helsinki. And I will just set up this. Wrong screen. See. There we go. And I have the pleasure now to introduce Anastasia. Can we help Anastasia with the mic?
Hello.
Okay, maybe you will need to, because normally you can just hold it. Perfect. And the stage is yours.
Hello guys, my name is Anastasia and I graduated in 2017 from service design and engineering track. So I'm gonna talk about energy today with you. And I guess energy is really important for us in our world. That where actually change is the only constant. We always have to change. We always have to grow professionally and personally. But without energy, we just cannot do that. And maybe some of you are like me, but like with this winter season coming, I feel like a little bit low energy. I don't want to do anything. I'm super lazy. So where do I find energy for personal professional development and for basically actions? I'm gonna tell you my story about how I got a very strong energy boost that actually helped me to change my life. So it helped me not only to change the place where I live and totally the social circle, but also totally change my profession. I became a software developer without any previous background in tech. And basically, my software development path started with EIT Digital Master School in 2015. It all started with a surf trip to Portugal. This is me, by the way. So I always was wondering about how is it surfing in the ocean. So I booked a surf trip to Portugal just for 3 days to try it out. And I couldn't wait to try surfing, except I had a big fear of waves and of the ocean. And my first day of surfing, it was quite stormy. It was raining, the wind was blowing, the ocean was super loud. I was almost crying of fear. But as soon as I took my first wave, actually my instructor pushed me to it, I felt so much energy. I felt that the world turned from being dangerous to being safe for me. I felt connection with everything, like with this beach, with this ocean. I felt super energized, and other days of my surf camp I dedicated to working with my fear of waves. And actually after my trip was finished, I began loving waves. And after that, when I returned home, I felt so much energy, so much curiosity towards the world, and so much creativity. I think I felt last time like that when I was like 5 years old kid. So that was amazing. And I decided, okay, I will start a project connected with surfing. So I decided that I will meet people around the world who changed their lives because of surfing, and that I will publish those inspirational stories on my website. And the first problem was for me how to create a website. For me, everything at that time, everything related to tech was like rocket science. But anyway, I started Googling. And in a couple of weeks, I first like set up something like a website. It was a WordPress-based website. But I was super happy because this creative process gave me so much like more energy that I decided, okay, I'm gonna study how to do it professionally. And next year, I was already packing my stuff to move to Trento to study EIT Digital Master School. So where is my energy from? By the way, this is my project. I forgot to change slides. And guys, it's still alive there on this link. And if you read Russian, you can, of course, visit it and read something about it. So the thing is that we as human beings, we have a lot of fears inside of us. And those fears, they block energy, and it is locked inside of our bodies, around here, like stomach. And the thing is that we have a chance to unlock it only if we start working with our fears. And I'm going to share with you the technology, like the technique, how to unlock your fears. So during my surfing trip, I worked with my fear of waves, and it was quite successful for me. So first, I recommend you to write down all of your fears, like all of them. Some basic fears, some really hard fears, like fear of death. And yeah, and analyze them. And imagine if each of them came true. And first of all, it's really important to accept that it's happened, accept the situation. And then think about three scenarios, the most horrible one, the most wonderful one, and the most probable one. And think about what are you gonna do, like at least three steps. What are you gonna do if these scenarios come true? And I recommend that you will feel much more relieved after this work, and you will get a lot of energy for some steps towards your goals. Because we are sometimes afraid of something that will never happen. So take a chance. Another source of energy is collaboration with our peers. Actually, we are so lucky in tech industry because we are surrounded by really creative and talented people. And we have a chance to work with them in a team in some project-related events, like hackathons, for example. I actually participated in Junction in 2016, and I could barely code myself that time. I had a lot of worries, and I wasn't confident in myself, and I was questioning, do I really have to participate? How can I contribute to my team? But anyway, since I'm trying to work on my fears, I participated, and guess what? I not only collaborated well and contributed well, but our team won IoT track in Junction, and actually that led me to my first programming job. I got a master project from Aalto University and became a researcher for 2 years. Without Junction, I don't think it could be possible. So I recommend you to team up with your peers and to learn from them, because you will get a lot of energy from people and you will learn something, of course. And the next source of energy that I'm gonna tell you about, you know, I think all of you know about conferences, tech-related events. And Slush is the one that I think majority of you will visit, and I recommend you to do so because it's an amazing event. And also in 2016, I visited this event, and I finally realized that Finland is a really great country. It's a really tech country, and I was very inspired that I started my studies here. And for example, three weeks ago, I was very depressed. I was like, okay, autumn depression. But I had a ticket to Web Summit. It's a big startup conference like Slush, but it's held in Lisbon. And I went there, and after 3 days, I was so energized again. Yeah, I'm super happy. I'm very inspired right now because I listen to a lot of tech talks. And I listen about projects of other people, what are they working on, which technologies do they use. And I finally understood how tech industry is important, how is it shaping our future. And since I'm part of it, I also will be shaping my future, our future. So this is very inspirational, and I recommend you to participate in some tech-related events, like, for example, our event today. I feel so inspired again. Thank you so much for organizing. So these are three ways to get energy. Work with your fears and try to overcome them. Collaborate with your peers and learn from them. Listen to other people and their projects. And yeah, please start working with your fears, guys. I recommend you. You will have some results. And if you want, you can share your progress with me. These are my contact details. And thank you so much for listening to me. I hope you found something useful. And also, thank you for the opportunity to share my knowledge, my experience with you. Thanks.
We also have something for you, and thanks Anastasia for sharing your experiences. And I think it's important to clarify, we when we're working in tech, most of the time, all we listen is stories about very things that are happening, seem to be so far away from us. But Anastasia is a graduate of the same program that you're studying, of the same program that some of you have already graduated. So we always want to bring a story that's close to you, because right now you're sitting there, but maybe in 2-3 years, you will be right here on the stage. And we are the Yetit alumni. So that means that all of you will be alumni someday. And you will also be able to share your experiences and the things you have lived and the challenges you have faced with newer generations. So that's why we believe it's important to listen to these kind of stories. That might not be about just the very technical things, but very tangible experiences that we all face. Going through a difficult, dark autumn, cold winter. Finland is not the easiest country, so be aware of that. But these are ways that you can overcome those challenges. So thanks, Anastasia, for that. And we also hope that you like the opera, because for you there is also an opera ticket inside of this envelope, which has a code, so that's why I don't show it to everyone, because they could see the code. But thanks again.
Thank you so much.